darkness, my old friend.
Okay, so then we get to Ben's 21st birthday. He's an exhibit again for his parents. He's in the scuba gear, again, symbolism. He's very uncomfortable. It's difficult to move because he's got the flippers on. There's a bit where it's sort of tragic and funny at the same time when his father's going, oh, let's bring out the birthday boy. And you can hear him going, Dad, can I talk to you? Dad, can we have a word? Something like that. It's very funny. And then it's really interesting. He sort of descends into the pool, which again is like a descent, and his father's literally pushes him under the water, doesn't he?
Right.
Dad's pushing him down. Is there any more symbolism in the scuba gear? What do you think?
You know, the obvious is you made a reference towards the little scuba man that was in his fish tank in the bedroom scene early on. And then now he is that scuba diver in the pool. The humor of it is surreptitious in a way. You know, and he's going, he has a harpoon gun and he's down there in the, but when he goes out, it's shot through a fish-eyed lens. And that's the thing, because he's wearing this mask, you know, playing this part in sort of all of what's expected of him. And so the fish-eyed lens of him coming out, and it's like, oh, we're celebrating this. And it's through that. And then, yeah, his father's pushing him back down underwater.
Yeah.
You know, the symbolism, I mean, it's not hard to map out. Like, basically, yeah, they're keeping him submerged.
That's it.
And his dad's saying, oh, he's going to do these depth-defying tricks and
all this stuff.
And then he just stands there, you know?
Yeah.
And it transitions from inside his mask. So we're Ben, and then all of a sudden, then we're looking at Ben. The next scene is him calling Miss Robinson.
He's sort of desperate enough. I don't mean that badly against Mrs. Robinson, but he clearly is very nervous about that, and he's scared of that idea. But he's so desperate by this point to just get away and just to make some change in his life.
Well, the whole fish tank theme runs throughout the film. There's an aquarium when they go to the hotel. So there's this whole idea that they're underwater, that they're in this...
In a fishbowl, but a goldfish bowl, it's that kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly. Actually, the bowl that you're in, right? And that's why you identify with the film. That's why the film's so successful, is you're inside your own bowl, viewing that on this rectangular screen. You're connecting with this, realizing you're identifying with it. Talking about the symbolism of the film. It does it in a symbolic way, and it's much more impactful because you're not told, you're shown, and you have these feelings and perceptions about it without being hit over the head with it.
No, it's funny because to use a popular expression, the symbolism is quite on the nose, but it gets away with it. I wouldn't even say it's obvious. Well, it's obvious if you're looking for it. If you're analyzing this film in order to make a podcast, as we are, it's pretty clear, you know, the sort of conveyor belt of life, you know, all that kind of thing. But it's not,
well, and that's
it's
people
not
like
clumsy.
Us. It's not clumsy at all.
No,
every single shot in that film is fucking deliberate and absolutely 100% made to convey something.